think the last couple of days there's been a lot of conflict amongst all of us, and I haven't been feeling great, so I think we need this time just to kind of regroup and just sort ourselves out. So come next week when the new arrivals come, whether they pick us or not, we just need to be back up on our game.
That's a good idea.
All right for that.
Cool.
Yeah. Right, I'm gonna address everything with you two. Both of you have been like pulling yourself away as a whole, like you are not fussed whether we're winning new arrivals. The whole group are feeling it deep down. Not everyone is as strong enough as me to stand up and say, yes Mackenzie, you're doing this, yes Xanthi, you're doing that. They might not come and say it to you, but they're really feeling it deep down. They really do have a problem with you two doing what you're doing.
Jack felt that there was too much of a leadership role, and it was, I think he kind of phrased it as it was you guys kind of leading the island.
We just saw you two kind of pushing yourself away a bit from the group, and like as Mark said, it was three sets of new arrivals, so it's obviously having an impact.
Oh, I wasn't rude to the new arrivals, I just wasn't always there with the new arrivals because I wasn't feeling it. Do you see what I mean? I don't came across to them, but that's not the only reason.
I spoke to Benny, and Benny even said, do they not realise they're losing the game if you keep playing like this?
I couldn't care less whether Benny came here or not, to be fair.
That's the problem.
I've been working my arse off, and this is annoying me now, because I've said to five individual people that I'm going to change, and I have changed, and me and Mackenzie, the person that I want to spend my time with, are spending less time together, and everybody's just kicking off all the time. I don't want to hear it anymore. People tell me what I want, I've heard it five times, I don't want to hear it again.
I personally think the sacred circle today was a load of rubbish, because what people are basically saying to me is spend less time with the people that I like spending time with, make more of an effort for people that I don't even really like, and also keep my opinions and mouth shut when it comes to certain things like island lore and things like that.
While sharks struggle to resolve their tensions, on tigers the outlook's no brighter.
Just to let you know, I'm not speaking to that guy. I don't know where he is now, but Kevin, feet. Personally, he's done nothing to deserve me speaking to him. Yeah. If he even tries to speak to me, the only thing I'm going to say to him, you've done nothing to deserve.
Yeah, but he's come over now, Liam.
He said they'd come over as sharks, but we can always try and persuade them. I mean, they didn't sound like they had that much fun at sharks.
Most people are quite welcoming to me, which I wasn't sure whether to expect that or not. Liam, in particular, is like the person who's been pointing out to me. He's taken it really personally.
But with all the focus on Kevin, someone's been forgotten.
I was the one who decided to come over here, and I'd made the decision to give them the opportunity to get to know me, but they somehow seemed to forget that, and it was all about why Kevin disrespected them, I think was the word used by a few. The tigers didn't seem very pleased. Some of them stormed off to their camp and forgot that I so was a new arrival, and didn't give me the attention I think I deserved.
While Benny's feeling ignored, Kevin's keen to clear the air.
I want you to know I am sorry, like, for disrespecting you and everything like that, and, like, you know my intention was not to do so.
I've seen a lot of things in my life, and that is one of the most disrespectful things I've ever seen.
My reasoning for it wasn't through any negative preconceptions I had with the tigers. It was purely the reason I wanted to stay was because of the positive aspects I found on the sharks.
While your time is here,
yeah,
you won't get any more animosity from me.
Cool.
All right, mate. You take it easy.
Safe. I think he still sort of has definite qualms with the decision I made earlier, and that's not going to go away really quickly.
But Kevin's determined to win the tribe over.
As my little gift to the tigers, I'm going to show off the one and only talent which I have, doing all 13 minutes of Rapper's Delight by the Sugar Hill Gang. I said a hip, a hop, a hip, a hip, into the hip, hip, hop, you don't stop, a rock to the bang, bang, boogie, sit up, jump the boogie to the rhythm of the boogie to beat. Now what you hear is not a test, I'm rapping to the beat, and me, the groove, and my friend.
So the night ends on a high note, for some at least.
I'd like to say hello, rock the black to the white, the red and the brown, the purple and yellow.
It's the first full day on Tiger Island for the new arrivals. Later they will impose island law, but that's the last thing on Benny's mind.
Sorry.
Oh, don't cry. What's up?
I just feel emotional about it all.
I just felt lost. I don't know, it wasn't, I didn't speak to you very much, in all fairness, it wasn't.
Seriously, don't think there's anything wrong with you.
I know it's not wrong with me, I know myself enough to know, but I think it's so out of order to make someone feel so uncomfortable somewhere.
Oh no, I didn't
even till today, even till now, I mean, I don't even know Liam, he hasn't even said, not even a hello, I don't even know who, I just think that's rude, I would never do that. I've had it more raw than the person that even decided that they didn't want to come in the first place.
Liam is,
you know, and I just think it's rude. Yeah. I think it's rude. At the end of the day, it's a game, but this is real people you're dealing with.
While Kevin takes Benny off for a heart-to-heart, the tribe gather for crisis talks.
We're all here to have a good time. We're all here to have an experience. And to be honest, I felt a bit disgusted in the tiger mentality. Fair enough, have a hold up against Kevin. He didn't want to come over. But to treat Benny in the same light and make her feel like a bit of dirt on your shoe.
She felt that there were some people that hadn't made any effort and some people who hadn't actually even greeted her and had the courtesy to say hello.
It shows bad team spirit, I think.
Liam, have you got anything to say on this?
Frankly not. I mean, I think everyone else's opinions is pretty much what I feel. So I don't feel like I need to bring my opinions to the table.
I think you do need to voice them because at the moment, Liam, this is about the fact that Benny was in tears this morning, okay? Because some people on this group could not be bothered with her.
The last thing we want to get out of this is to lose two new arrivals and then get a nomination or something if we keep breaking down. Sorry. We've got to keep it tight.
To be honest, I don't want to be in a group that's like this.
Sonny, where are you going? No, man, what is...
This is the problem. I just feel like we're actually breaking down.
The reason this is so good is because we are so close, such a brilliant family together. And look at us now.
Yeah.
I was really disappointed with Sonny walking off. I just think no matter how somebody feels, the reason you talk about it is to get things behind you. And I think as soon as somebody walks off, that's game over, that's finished. We haven't achieved anything.
Liam just kind of stayed quiet, and for all his big opinions and the amount of damage that he's caused, I think he should have had much more to say.
As the meeting gets them nowhere, Benny decides to take matters into her own hands.
Thanks to everyone that's made me feel welcome on Tigers. I think you all know who you are, and those of you that haven't made me feel very welcome, I'd like to say I'm a bit disappointed.
I'll be specific as to the ones that were nice and welcoming to me. And those of you that weren't, whatever your reasons were, I thought that it's immature. I think that at the end of the day, this might just be a game to you, but there are feelings involved. And maybe you need to think about that in the process of trying to get a new arrival.
I'm so sorry, Benny, that you have to say that.
Do you feel like that you haven't felt welcome or whatever? We want to definitely turn that around.
Yeah, that's well said. Maybe some people should respond to what's been said.
Are you willing to give us as a tribe again? Especially with the involvement of me, I'm sure Liam will be bad enough to join in as well, and Sonny, a second chance at trying to impress you, because I'm willing to do it.
Thank you very much. I would, yeah, love to talk to you and get to know you. I'm just letting you know how I felt and how I felt from yesterday.
With the air cleared, Benny turns her attention to island law.
So if I throw this one there.
Yeah.
She wants the tribe to improve the shelter, and the boys show willing.
This one, the first one always starts off going left.
No.
Come on.
But there is one exception.
And Liam's the one. He's not chosen to come and say anything to me or apologise for the way he behaved or to take part in the rules that I've set. So he's not helping us with anything. I don't know why.
Liam's behaviour is the final straw for Hermione.
I feel the whole group has crumbled as a result. Not only have you basically tried to scare away the new arrivals, but I think people like Jack and Della, if I was them, I'd be over at Charles as soon as possible.
I've been dealing with a lot of stuff over the past, 2 weeks, and basically a very strong part of me wants to go home.
It's the morning of the beach party. Later today, the new arrivals will have to decide which island to live on. But first, Liam has something to share with the tribe.
Everyone can have a quick chat, please. I just want to apologise for my actions in the last few days. But basically, I'm fighting the urge to not want to be here. I wake up every morning and I just don't want to be here anymore. When I go off by myself, I'm not sulking. I'm just trying to work things out in my head.